Hello students, welcome to online computer classes. Myself Dr. Kajal Rai, and today we are going to discuss another important lesson of software engineering, which is a very important topic, and it is waterfall model. We today going to discuss about what is the waterfall model, what are the phases in it, and when to use the waterfall model and when not to use it. So let's first of all, we should know what is SDLC. SDLC is Software Development Life Cycle, in which the software build and all the activities we do in building a software, it is called Software Development Life Cycle. System development activities that involve or produce a solution to some organization or institution problems, it is Software Development Life Cycle. All the activities involving in that process to make up a solution to a problem. And developing information system solution is a multi-step process. It is an iterative process which is called software development life cycle. And this software development life cycle involves various models, not only waterfall model, it includes various models such as waterfall model, spiral model, iterative enhancement model, and so on. But the basic and the first very simple model is waterfall model, which was widely used in which is widely used, of course, but we have to discuss each and every model in separate classes. This today we are going to discuss only about the waterfall model. So what is waterfall model? Waterfall model have five phases. It has five phases. The phases always occur in the order in which I am going to show it to you, and it does not overlap. The first phase is requirement analysis and specification phase. Second is design phase. Third is implementation and unit testing phase. And fourth one is integration and system testing phase. And the last one is operation and maintenance phase. These are the five phases of a waterfall model. And each phase does its work. And only after the previous phase is completed, the next phase begins. It does not overlap. And two phases cannot begin simultaneously. In this way, waterfall model works. Diagram of waterfall model, that is why we call this waterfall, because first the requirement analysis is done, then design is done, then implementation is in. It's like steps or waterfall, you can say, just like the natural waterfall. So that's why it got its name from there only. It is called waterfall model because of these phases. So when to use the waterfall model, this is the very important thing. We should know when to use it and when to not. So the first is when we should use waterfall model is when we already know the requirements, in which the requirements are very well known and clear, and it is fixed and it is not changing the requirements. Some organization always change on their requirements for the product or software, but in that case we don't use waterfall model. When the requirements are fixed and stable, then only we use the waterfall model. And the technology also should be very clear about. We should have all knowledge of all the technologies which we are going to use in our implementation of waterfall model. And there are no ambiguous requirements. For example, they should not say this is done or this is not to be done. They should have clear definition of what they are going to, what the organization is demanding, what their goals, what they have to achieve. They should be clear in their requirements, then only we can use it. And there are also some ample resources available with the expert eyes. And the project, most important is the project should be short. It is not suitable for large scale products. So the project should be short and the requirements are very well known, then only we use waterfall model. Now let's begin with the first phase of waterfall model, which is requirement analysis and specification phase. The goal of this phase is to understand the exact requirement of the customer. and to document them properly also. This activity is usually executed together with the customer or the end user which is going to use this product or software. And we have to document all the functions, performance and interfacing requirements for the software. That is why we include the customer in it on the end user in it. The requirements describe what of a system, what the system should do, what this system is doing, and not how to do it. Okay, so this is very important difference, that the requirements describe what the system will do and not how it did do it. This phase produces a large document which is written in a natural language, of course, which contains the description of what the system will do without describing how it will be done, and the resultant document is called software requirement specification, SRS document. This SRS document later may then act as a contract between the developer and the customer. If the developer fails to implement full set of requirements, it may amount to failure to implement the contracted system. And also the end user or the customer or the organization which is giving the contract to the developer to develop such a system, they cannot then deny that we had given these type of requirements only and not the further one. So this is beneficial for both developer as well as the organization. This SRS document is very beneficial. This design phase, the SRS document, software requirement specification document, which is produced in the previous phase, which contains the exact requirements of the customer. The goal of the design phase is to transform the requirement specification into structure that is suitable for implementation in any some programming language. This design phase specifies how system will meet information needs of a user. It is the overall plan of that system, like the blueprint of a building. This specification should address all the managerial, organization and technical components of system solution. Hence, overall system architecture is defined and the high level and the detailed design work is performed. This work is also documented and it is known as software design description document. And this software design description should be sufficient to begin the coding phase, of course. And the implementation and unit testing phase. During this phase, a design is implemented. If the SDD, which is software design description, is complete, the implementation of coding phase proceeds smoothly because all the information needed by the software development is already there in the SDD. So during implementation, physical system specification is converted into working and reliable software and hardware. During testing, the major activities are centered around the examination and modification of the code. Initially, small modules are tested in isolation from the rest of the software product. And before testing, the coders will convert the physical requirements into the working condition or working program system. And each module is converted into a set of instructions, and after coding the testing process is also begin side by side. We can begin, but in waterfall model we do it after coding, only when the full coding has been done. And each module needs to be tested individually first and then as a part of the larger. So in testing, first the purpose of the testing is to check whether the system produces the correct results, of course. Then we can say that our system is good or not. Initially, small modules are tested in isolation from the rest of the software. We can't test all the system together. So we first do it unit testing and then the system testing. Next phase is integration and system testing phase. In this, all the functions are put together, integrated. Then the system testing is done System testing involves the testing of the entire system. It is a very expensive and time consuming activity, and it consumes 1/3 of the cost of development project. Next phase is operation and maintenance phase. So software maintenance is a task that every development group has to face. When the software is delivered to the customer side, installed and is operational. Therefore, release of software inaugurates the operation and maintenance phase of the life cycle. The time spent and effort required to keep the software operational after release is very significant. Despite the fact that it is very important and challenging task, it is sometimes poorly managed. That leads to more time and effort to do the maintenance. Software maintenance is a very broad activity that includes the correction three steps categories: corrective maintenance, adaptive maintenance, and perfective maintenance. And then all these phases together may span for 5 to 50 years, whereas the development may be to 1 to 3. What is corrective maintenance? Corrective maintenance implies removing errors in the program due to faulty design or wrong assumption. Sometimes we take it. So this is the corrective maintenance. Then in corrective maintenance, the performance failures are repaired. This is adaptive maintenance. As the name suggests, in adaptive maintenance, program functions are changed to enable the system to satisfy the information needs of the user or the changing needs of the organization. Next is perfective maintenance. Perfective maintenance is undertaken to respond to users' additional needs due to changes in the organization or outside the organization. The environmental changes include changing in the policies of government and laws, changing in the new technology when you adopt new technologies, and so on. So these are the things which maintenance we do: corrective maintenance, adaptive maintenance, and perfective maintenance. Next, these are all the phases of waterfall model, and we already studied when to use the waterfall model. But now, what are the problems in waterfall model? This is the very initial model and very widely used model, but what is the problem? What are the problems in it? So the first problem is, it is difficult to define all the requirements at the beginning of the project, because waterfall model says that we should know all the requirements before we start implementing or designing or coding anything in the waterfall model. All the requirements should be stabilized in the requirement phase only. So this is very difficult thing in any software or in any project. And this model is not suitable for accommodating any changes. After you have fixed the SRS, then you can't change any requirements, and the model is not suitable for any changes. And third problem is, the working version of the system is only seen in the later, very late in the life cycle, because we fix the requirements, then we co-design, then we do coding, and then we do implementation. And after implementation only we see the working version of the software, of the project or software. And it is not suitable for the large scale projects. As I already told, it is only suitable for the small scale projects, because in small scale, we can fix the requirements up to some extent. But in the large projects, day by day, the information, the requirement changes due to the need in the organization or due to the technology changes, because the large project will take large time to build it, to develop it. That's why the requirement changes in between.